It's Professor Dave. Let's introduce the distributive property.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
As we learn math, we will see that there are certain properties of numbers that are very important. We already learned about the commutative property and the associative property, and we saw how addition and multiplication abide by these properties, while subtraction and division do not. Now let's learn another property, the distributive property. To see how this works, let's look at some more apples. Say we have 5 piles of 7 apples. 5 piles times 7 apples per pile gives us 35 apples. What if we split each pile up into a group of 3 and a group of 4? There are a few ways we could represent this. Let's take the 7 and split it up into 3 plus 4, in parentheses. This is clearly the same value we once had, because 3 plus 4 is 7, which makes sense because rearranging the apples shouldn't change the number of them that are present. But we could also say that we have 5 piles of 3 and 5 piles of 4. That means 5 times 3 plus 5 times 4. Visually, we are just describing what we see, but mathematically, we have just derived the distributive property. When we have a number that is multiplied by a sum or difference, we can distribute that number across each value within the sum or difference. In this case, that means 5 times 3 plus 5 times 4. That gives us 15 plus 20, which is indeed still 35. So whether we add the numbers in the parentheses first and then multiply by the other number, or distribute the number across the sum, we will get the same result, and that is the essence of the distributive property, which will be very important once we get to algebra. We can even use this property in reverse. Let's say we have 5 times 17. If we don't want to write down a calculation, we can easily do this in our heads if we split 17 up into 10 plus 5 plus 2. Now we can distribute the 5 across the sum and rewrite this as 5 times 10 plus 5 times 5 plus 5 times 2. These can be done easily in your head, and we get 50 plus 25 plus 10, and that's 85. This sort of mental trickery is very useful for multiplying large numbers, so let's move on to that topic next. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.